Hello friends, first of all a very warm welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So we have currently 10 series that focus on your prelims and one series that is mains oriented. So what we do in these prelim series, we daily pick up two topics and we discuss MCQs of those topics, and in this manner we will continue to do so till 31st May, because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC, CSE, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's see what are the questions of today. So before starting the today's lecture, let me request to you people that please subscribe to our channel and please do not forget to press the bell icon, because if you want to remain in tune with our channel, then you have to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications. So let's start friends discussion of today. So today is the first lecture of current affairs series, so we have just started it. So let's see what is the first question. The first question is related to International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women. So we have to consider certain statements about this day. First is, it is observed every year on 25th November. Second, the theme this year was Orange the World, Hear Me Too. Three, this day is commemorated in memory of Mirabal sisters, who were three political activists from Dominican Republic. So we have to choose which of the above statements are correct. So let me tell you friends that all of these statements are correct. Yes, the day for elimination of violence against women is observed on 25th November every year, and the theme this year was Orange the World, Hear Me Too. And also it is commemorated in the memory of Mirabal sisters, who were basically three political activists from Dominican Republic, who were brutally murdered for their activities, for their political activities. So friends, all of these statements are correct. So the answer would be here, that is 1, 2, and 3. So the answer would be D. So here is the explanation part. So here is definition that is given by the United Nations General Assembly. So it is any act of gender-based violence that results in or it is likely to result in physical or sexual or psychological harm. So including the such threats also. So why we should eliminate it? Because there is a lot of prevalence of violence against women, and this largely remains unreported due to impunity, due to the silence, and also stigma and shame associated with the incidents. So friends, this is the various forms in which it figures, and this is some data shown here, so you can see them in the explanation PDF. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, consider the following statements about emergency response support system. First, it was launched recently by Haryana to ensure women's safety. Second, it is exclusively available for women. So which of the above statements is incorrect? So we have to choose which of the above statement is incorrect. So let me tell you friends, please note the word incorrect. So we have to choose incorrect statement. So let me tell you friends that the first statement is incorrect, because it was not launched by Haryana government. It was launched by Himachal Pradesh government to ensure women's safety. So it is also exclusively available for women. So if our second statement is correct, but we have to choose the incorrect one. So the first statement is incorrect. So the answer would be B. So solution is B. So here is the explanation. So basically Himachal Pradesh is the first state to launch single emergency number 112 under the emergency response support system. So it will connect to police, fire, health and other helplines, and also it has a shout feature exclusively available for women. So when they will press it, the volunteers that have registered themselves, they will get the notification and they will become alert, and this also the emergency response center will come for immediate assistance. So friends, this is basically the funding for this scheme will come from the Nirbhaya fund. So here is the explanation about Nirbhaya fund. So it is basically measured, it is managed by Department of Economic Affairs, Ministry of Finance. So it is basically to eradicate violence against women and girls. So it was made in the wake of protests that followed the 2012 Delhi gang rape. So it is placed under the Department of Economic Affairs and Ministry of Finance. So but let me tell you, yes, it is under the management of Department of Economic Affairs, but in actual practice, who approves the funding out of this fund, who approves that the schemes are entitled to draw the money from the fund, it is the Ministry of Women and Child Development, which praises or recommends the proposals or schemes to be funded under the Nirbhaya fund. So let's move on to the third question. The third question is, consider the following statements about the Competition Commission of India. So there are certain statements about Competition Commission of India, and we have to consider these statements. First, it is an executive body directly under the control of union government. Second, its objectives among others are to prevent practices having adverse effect on competition, to protect the interests of consumers, and to ensure freedom of trade. Third, recently it organized a national conference on public procurement and competition law in association with Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs, that is under the aegis of Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So we have to choose which of the following statements are correct. So let me tell you, friends, that it is not an executive body. It is a statutory body, and it is especially created under Competition Commission Act 2002. So its objective is to ensure that the markets in India remain fair, and there are no kind of activities that prevent the competition. So it is basically to the objective of the commission is to promote competition. And yes, it recently organized a national conference on public procurement and competition law in association with Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs, which comes under the patronage of Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So which of the following statements is correct? Second and third only. So the answer would be C. So here is the explanation. So Ashok Kumar Gupta has been recently appointed as the chairperson of Competition Commission of India. So it was established in 2002, and it came into the act was made in 2002, and this body was made in 2019. So chairperson and members are appointed by the central government, and these are the objectives about which you can read in the explanation. So here is Competition Commission Act. So it prohibits anti-competitive agreements, abuse of dominant position by enterprises, and regulates combinations, that is acquisitions, acquiring of control, and this merger and acquisition, and which causes or likely to cause an adverse effect on competition within India. So let's move on to the fourth question. The fourth question is, consider the following statements about Constitution Day. So we have to consider the certain statements about Constitution Day. First, it is observed every year on 26th November. Second, while the Constitution was adopted on this day, but it was enacted on 26th January 1950. The significance this year was that for the first time the Constitution will be made available in Braille. So this is a pattern, friends, in which the blind people which is blind people friendly. So which of the above statements are correct? So we have to choose the correct statements. So friends, let me tell you that this all of these statements are correct. It is observed every year on 26th November because on this day the Constitution was adopted, but it was enacted on 26th January 1950. And also, friends, yes, this time the significance is that for the first time this Constitution is made available in Braille. I don't know how to pronounce it properly, so sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong. So the solution is A, that is 1, 2 and 3. All the statements are correct. So earlier, learning portion. Earlier this day was commemorated as National Law Day, but now it is celebrated as the Constitution Day. And the celebration this year are it is a collective effort of Buddhist Association for Blind and Savvy Foundation and Swagat Thorat. So this time this is available in Braille, that is for the benefit of visually challenged individuals. So let's move on to the fifth question, the last question of today's topic of current affairs. Fifth question is, consider the following statements regarding Dredging Corporation of India. First, government has made strategic disinvestment of 100% of its share in Dredging Corporation of India Limited recently to consortium of four ports. Second, the consortium of four ports consists of Vishakhapatnam Port Trust, Andhra Pradesh, Paradeep Port Trust, Odisha, Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust, Maharashtra, and Kandla Port Trust, Gujarat. So here we have been asked to choose which of the following which of the above statements are incorrect. So please note the word incorrect. So we have to choose the incorrect statement. So let me tell you, friends, both the statements are correct. So there is no statement that is incorrect. So the answer would be D, that is none. So UPSC has the habit of confusing you in such type of questions. So both these statements are correct. You might take C, that is both 1 and 2. But let me tell you, here it is asking which of the following is incorrect. So that would be D. So basically it is Dredging Corporation of India Limited is a mini ratna. It earlier came under the Ministry of Shipping, and it was engaged in the business of dredging and also other things of relating to dredging. And currently the government has recently in November month disinvested 100% of its share in this Dredging Corporation of India Limited. Earlier it holded 73.44% shares, but now it sold all these shares to the consortium of four ports that I have mentioned you, that is Visakhapatnam Port Trust in Andhra Pradesh, and there is Kandla Port in Maharashtra, as I have told you, and there is also Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust in Maharashtra and Kandla Port Trust Gujarat, and Paradip Port Trust Odisha. And benefits are will be like if the dredging corporation will be acquired by ports, so mostly the dredging needs are of ports, because they have to undertake the dredging activity continuously for maintaining appropriate depth of water, so that the ships can move themselves on the shores. So this is basically acquired by these ports. So now they can use it, and they can also get more profit by using its technology, and also by more profit they can invest in more kind of, we can say, technology. For it provides opportunities for larger investment in DCIL, that is Dredging Corporation of India Limited. So here is explanation. It is a Minuratna public sector, and it was established in March 1976, and it is headquartered in Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. So it reports to the Ministry of Shipping. So it does dredging for India seaports exclusively, it is involved in capital dredging, beach nourishment, and land reclamation. So friends, these are the questions of today. If you like the questions, please like it, and if you like the video, please share it with your friends. And lastly friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these discussions that we are doing on our channel, then you can contact us on this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com. Or you can directly contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So friends, why these PDFs are important? Because at the end of the day, you will not be able to see 15 to 20 minute long video, because that will be a utter wastage of time. And also at that time, you will have to revise multiple topics. So obviously you can't see 15 to 20 minute long video, and also you can't read the standard books, or for that matter, the NCERTs, or for that matter some magazines, because at that time you must have some kind of handy notes you can revise quickly, and in which the explanation is given quite comprehensively, so that you are able to revise your syllabus quickly and at least 4 or 5 times before you enter the prelims exam hall. So friends, in that case, these PDFs will help you, because these are in the MCQ format, so you will not get bored by reading them again and again. You will first see the question, and then you will go for its answer, and then you will go for its explanation. So in this manner, you will be revising your important concepts comprehensively. So if you want to subscribe to these PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, and also the contact number is 8968426481. So friends, this is all about today's video, and if you like the video, please like it, and also do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon. So friends, thank you. Have a nice day.